Hello everyone, I am Professor Shruti Dixit, Assistant Professor in Electronics and Communication Department, Sagar Institute of Research and Technology. This college is under SAGE Group. Today we are going to discuss the topic from the subject Computer System Organization, Asynchronous Data Transfer. This is topic from third unit. As we have discussed the different data transmission methods, serial transmission as well as parallel transmission. The serial transmission is again subdivided into synchronous transmission and asynchronous transmission. In case of asynchronous transmission, the data transfer between two independent units and the data will be sent in the form of goods groups with start bit and stop bit. The timing is not important. There will be not fixed timing between these sending of group of data, but in case of synchronous transmission, the timing is very important. The common clock means the sender and receiver will derive the timing information from common clock line. Asynchronous data transfer methods is again divided into two types, strobe pulse and handshaking. Strobe pulse is the one extra signal instead of the original data. The strobe pulse is supplied by one unit. One unit means again under this strobe pulse we will discuss source initiated strobe and destination initiated strobe. A strobe pulse is supplied by one unit to indicate the other unit when the actual transfer of data has to occur. In case of handshaking, data pulse will be there, then strobe pulse will be there, as well as a control signal is accompanied with each data being transmitted to indicate the presence of data. Means in case of strobe pulse, there is no feedback system is available, but in handshaking, the feedback system is available. So we will understand the strobe control from these two diagrams, source initiated strobe for data transfer and destination initiated strobe for data transfer. As this is the block diagram of source initiated, here there is one source unit and destination unit, and there are two buses are connected between the source and destination, data bus and strobe. The data bus is used to carry the data from source unit to destination unit, and this is the direction is same. The strobe pulse is the meaning of the strobe pulse is after sending the strobe pulse from the source unit to destination, means that the valid transmission of data is started towards the destination unit. And this is the timing diagram for source initiated. Here the data bus through this data bus, the actual data will be transmitted. And after some time, the strobe pulse will be initiated by the source to inform the destination that actual data transfer is started now. But here the destination will not give any response to the source unit. So source unit will be unaware that the data will be transmitted or not. Properly transmitted or not. In case of destination initiated, first the strobe signal will be initiated or given by the destination unit to indicate that the now I am ready and you can send the data. Then after that strobe signal, the source unit will start to send the data. So first the strobe signal will be generated, and then the actual transmission of data will be started, the falling edge of the strobe signal indicates that the valid data transmission will be stopped. There are few disadvantages of this method. In case of source initiated, the source unit that initiates the transfer has no way of knowing whether the destination unit has actual data received or not, means no feedback system from the destination actual data reception or not. But in case of destination initiated, the destination unit that initiates the transfer, no way of knowing whether the source has actually placed the data on the bus or not. So to overcome this problem, the handshake method is introduced. Second control signal for providing a reply to the unit that initiates the transfer, for giving the reply to the source unit, so that the source unit can know the data will be received by the destination. So this is the example of source initiate transfer using handshake. Here the three data lines are there: data bus, data valid, and data accepted. Here first the data bus, through this data bus the valid data will be transmitted, and this data valid is actually basically the strobe signal for to initiate the destination unit that the actual data transfer is started. And the data accepted, after some time delay the destination unit will initiate the data accepted signal towards this source unit. And these are the sequence of events. First the placing of data on the data bus is in, and then enable the data valid. Then destination unit will accept the data from bus, and enable data will be accepted. And after the accepting the data, the disable data valid signal will be there, and invalidate data on bus, and then disable data accepted, ready to accept the data, and again it will go to the new placement of data on data bus. It allows the arbitrary delays from one state to the next state, then permits each unit to respond at its own data transfer rate. The rate of transfer is determined by the slower unit. In case of destination initiated handshaking method, here the source will first the ready for data signal will be initiated by the destination unit that the destination is ready to accept data. Then after getting this signal from the destination unit, this source unit will start to send the data. So these are the sequence of events. First the destination unit will send the signal towards this source unit that I am ready to accept the data, enable ready for data, then the placement of data on data bus, enabling the data valid signal. Then after that data will be accepted by the destination unit, and then disable ready for data, means if after disabling the ready for data, this data valid signal and data bus will be disabled. Handshaking provides a high degree of flexibility and reliability because the successful completion of data transfer relies on active participation by both units. And if one unit is faulty, then the data transfer will not be completed, and it can be detected by means of a timeout mechanism. So we can say that the handshaking method is more reliable and efficient method in comparison with strobe control method. Thank you.